So, welcome guys to our lesson. I hope Yazid can come back and hope I can see more students today. So guys, today we are going to have a listening class. So we are going to listen. We were supposed to listen to some tracks, but maybe inshallah next time. So I'm going to read the passages, and I hope that Asia and Muhammad will read after me. So guys, if you have mics, just bring them, plug them in your computers, and try to read with me in the class today, because it's about reading and listening today. So the title is What Do You Do? So we are going to talk about it. Again, the lesson is by me, Abdulkareem Amin, and prepared by Faisal Ahmed Halawi. So are you ready, guys? Are you ready, guys? Okay, good, yes. Muhammad is okay. Yes, sir. Asya, try to be active. Okay. Okay, good. So, as I said, it's a listening class today. So, the goals from the lesson, prepare students for listening activities. Give students practice listening to different speakers, situations, and events. As I told you, we were supposed to have some track to hear native speakers, but maybe inshallah for next time we have a listening, I will play the recorder. This time I'm going to read. So welcome back, Yazid, and help students to understand conversational English. So Yazid, is everything okay? Okay, good. So this is the title, guys. What do you do? Who can explain this? Who can tell me what is the meaning of what do you do? If someone asks you, what do you do, Asya, or what do you do, Muhammad, or what do you do, Yazid? What do you think he wants? What kind of information he wants? If you guys ask me, what do you do? What do you think the answer should be? Try to give me something in English. Even if it's not correct in spelling, I will correct it for you. It's okay. So this is the question. This is the title. I am studying. Okay. So I am having a lesson. I am studying. S-T-U. S-T-U. So you can say I am a student. I am a student. Okay. Let me give you like, yeah, this is studying. Okay, so guys, what do you do? If someone asks about what do? He usually means what's your job? No? What's your job? But if I said, look at this question. If I said, what are you doing now, for example? Okay? Here, I would like to have the answer of Muhammad. I am studying English, or I am attending an English class, or I am having an English lesson. Okay, I am not studying the lesson. No, I am attending an English class. I am having an English lesson, or I am studying. Just you can say, I am studying English. So if someone asks you, what do you do? He means that what's your job? For me, I am a teacher. For you guys, you are students. So this is the answer. But for this question, what are you doing now, for example, or what are you doing? Then you can explain what are you doing at the moment. I am studying, I am writing, I am working, I am eating, whatsoever. Okay? Is it clear, guys? Okay. Come on, guys. Yeah, be active. So guys, we are going now to listen and discuss this passage. Again, as I told you, we were supposed to have a track to play it, but maybe inshallah for next time. So I am going to read them twice for you, I'm going to read them two times. After that, I want you guys to read after me. So I'm going to open your mics and I need some students to read with me. So I'm going to read this and then I'm going to read this one. And then I'm going to read this one again and this one again. And after that, I want you guys to read with me. Okay? Because the idea is that you want to learn. So you have to listen for me first. After that, you have to practice. You have to read. This is how you are going to learn English. Okay, after that you are going to have some questions. You are going to have a discussion about this passage. So, listen and discuss. Look at the information about the boys. What do they want to be? So we are talking about the future. What do they want to be? What are their dreams? Their goals in the future. So let's look at the first guy here. His name is Majid. He is 14 years old. So this is his age. He is 14 years old. Or you can say he is 14. Interests. He is interested in. He likes. He loves to do some things like sports, video games, and tennis. So this is the things that he enjoys doing. He enjoys doing sports, he enjoys playing video games, and he enjoys playing tennis or maybe watching tennis. So Majid wants to become a famous tennis player. I don't think that I can speak Arabic as here, but I think it's okay, it's clear, it's like short. It's a short passage. Welcome, Allah. As here, it's not that difficult. Name, Majid. Age, 14. Interests, hobbies, things that you love to do. So he loves to play sports, maybe football or basketball. He loves playing video games. He loves tennis, playing or watching. Majid wants to become a famous tennis player. Okay? So guys, forget about Arabic in my classes. Just forget about Arabic. I'm trying to speak simple English for you to understand. This is your opportunity to hear someone speak English all the time. I mean, for listening to someone speak English for 30 or 40 minutes is something amazing for you. By time, you will be excellent in English. Just forget about Arabic, please. In my class, just forget about Arabic. So this is the first guy, Majid. The second guy, or the second boy, his name is Adnan. Adnan, he is also 14 years old, so maybe they are classmates. Interests. You can Google it, guys, if you don't know what's the meaning of interest. I told you, hobbies, something that you like to do, something you enjoy to do. If you still didn't get the meaning, just Google it and you will understand it. But I think it's clear. Yeah, hobbies, not hopes, hobbies. H-O-B-B-I-E-S. So, interest, he's interested in technology, in gadgets, and in high-tech design. Technology, gadgets, high-tech design. Gadgets, guys, okay, this is gadgets. So, a gadget is a small tool such as a machine. So this is the meaning of gadget, is a small tool such as a machine that has a particular function. So it's like a tool, something that you want to do. Okay, something you can use to do things. Hobbies, H-O-B-B, not P-B, B from book, Muhammad. So again, Adnan, he is interested in technology. Yup, this is it, Muhammad. Technology, gadgets, and high-tech design. The G is silent, high-tech design. Adnan wants to become a high-tech designer, so this is his dream in the future. So now I'm going to just read it again quickly, and then I'm going to see who wants to read. So you have to prepare yourselves, guys. Okay, so just I'm going to read it again quickly. So the first guy, his name is Majid. He is 14 years old. He likes sports, video games, and tennis. Majid wants to become a famous tennis player. Name the second one, Adnan, or Adnan, 14 years old. He likes technology, gadgets, high tech design, from technology, tech design. Adnan wants to become a high-tech designer. This is the noun, high-tech designer. So, who wants to start reading? Who wants to be the first students to read? I see that Asia and Muhammad and Yazid have mics. Allah doesn't have a mic. So Muhammad will start. Okay, so Muhammad, I need you to read this. You can say name, Majid, age, 14, interest, like this, okay? And then go here and read this information. Okay, Muhammad, so Muhammad will start. But Muhammad, make sure that you don't have any noise around you, okay? Because we want to hear you clearly. So, are you ready, Muhammad? Okay, go ahead, Muhammad.
Name, Majid. Age, 14. Interests, sports, video games, or tennis. Majid wants to become a famous tennis player. Name, Adnan. Age, 14. Interests, technology, gadgets, high-tech design. Adnan wants to become a high-tech designer.
Again.
Adnan wants...
Just the last one.
To become... a high-tech designer.
Okay, thank you so much, Muhammad. That was excellent for Muhammad. Perfect for Muhammad. Perfect speaking, clear voice. Excellent, amazing. So, who else? Asya Yazid. Come on, you have to be brave. It's short, it's not that tall. I mean, they are just simple words. I mean, it's not that difficult. So, Yazid, do you want to read? Okay, good. So, Yazid is the second one. So, go ahead, Yazid. Just wait a minute. So I send the mic for Yazid, but just we have to wait. Okay, go ahead, Yazid. Yazid, we cannot hear you. I cannot hear anything. Yazid, I'm going to send it again. Try to check your mic because I cannot hear anything. يزيد maybe Yazid has a problem, I don't know. Yazid, we cannot hear you. I'm sorry. Try to check your editing. Okay, so Asia, do you want to read? You are not forced, of course, but I hope that you can do it. Okay, good. So Yazid, try to check your computer after, and we will see Asia now. So go ahead, Asia. Just wait for the mic. Still waiting for Asia. Okay, so Asia, again, I'm going to send it again. You have to accept the request in order to be able to speak. Then it's not working now, then we have to move on to the next slide. It's probably not going to work with Asia or Yazid. Maybe for next class, guys, tomorrow, inshallah, inshallah, tomorrow we are going to have a reading class. So try to check your computers, check the internet, check your mics tomorrow before you come. Okay, no, it's fine, Asia. So we have to move, guys, because we don't want to waste our time because we still have some things to go through. So, guys, remember the information because we're going to, I'm going to ask you some questions about them now. So let's move on. Thank you, Asia. Thank you, Muhammad. Thank you, Yazid. Allah, say something, please. So the first question for Asia. Guys, please don't answer unless I tell you. Let's make it organized, okay? So the first question is for Asia from the passage, Asia. You have to answer, of course, it's a comprehension, so you have to answer yes or no. So the first one, Asia, Majid wants to be a teacher, yes or no? Majid wants to be a teacher, no. Okay, we will check the answers after in the next slide. Number two, Muhammad, Adnan wants to be a designer. Adnan wants to be a designer, yes or no? What do you think, Muhammad? Yes, good. Number three is for Yazid. Majid designs games. Pay attention to this one. Designs game, yes or no, Yazid? Yazid said yes. What do you think, Asya and Muhammad? Remember, guys. Design, not play. No. So I will put yes here and no here, and we will see who got the correct answer. So the last one, Adnan is interested in technology. For all of you guys, for all of you, Asim, Muhammad, and Yazid. Adnan is interested in technology, yes or no? We are talking now about Adnan. So is he interested in technology, yes or no? Come on, I need three answers. Asya, Muhammad, Yazid. Adnan is interested in technology, yes or no? Adnan is the second boy. Adnan is the second boy. So Muhammad said yes, Asya said yeah, and Yazid said yes. So I have three yeses. Okay, so I have an agreement here. So let's check the answers. Okay. So the first one was correct for Asya. No, Majid doesn't want to be a teacher. He wants to be a professional tennis player. Yes, Adnan wants to be a designer. No, Majid doesn't design games. He play games. He play. He doesn't design them. The one who designs is Adnan. Adnan is the one who is interested in designing. Majid is interested in playing. He likes sport, tennis, video games. He just wants to play, and Adnan wants to design. So number four is okay. Adnan is interested in technology. So perfect, guys. Your answers were amazing. So thank you. So let's go now to the next one. So guys, these are vocabulary questions, okay? It's not in the passage, so I need to check your knowledge of English. What's the name of the job? Okay, so we have plays tennis, works in our hospital, teaches at school, designs new gadgets. So I'm going with Asya. Asya, what's the name of the job for the person who plays tennis? What do we call him? The person who plays tennis. He is what? It was mentioned with Majid. The person who wants to play tennis, he will be what? A tennis player. Good. Muhammad, just wait for Asya to think. But your answer is okay. So, a tennis player. So, this is the first one. So, number two, Yazid, works in a hospital. What do you think? Works in a hospital. You can have two answers. No, it's fine, Muhammad. Works in a hospital. We can have two answers. Okay, Asya, go. Yazid will answer number three. Okay? Asya, go, because Asya was supposed to answer number one. So guys, I can expect two answers here. Who works in a hospital? What do you call the people who work in a hospital? You can have actually more than two, but give me the famous two. Come on guys, Asya, Muhammad, Yazid, just give me the answers, guys. I will see who is the first one. So, is he a teacher? Do you think, guys, the teacher works in a hospital? So, answer Mr. Abdullah. So, doctor or a nurse? Yeah, so Mr. Abdullah had it wrong. Doctor or nurse? Yep, that's it. Doctor or nurse? Asya, try to be fast. So, doctor or nurse? Yeah. What about number three, guys? Where are you, Yazid? Teaches at school. Who is the guy who teaches at school? What do you call the guy who teach you in school? The guys who teach you in school. Teacher, brother. So Muhammad is the active one and the rest are lazy. Come on, guys. Yazid, Asya. Muhammad is going to win the iPhone and you are going to sleep. Be active. So, designs new gadgets. So what do we call him? The guy who designed. Remember, Adnan. This is for Adnan. We can say designer and we can say something else. What does Adnan wants to be? So designer is acceptable, but high. Remember what I said about high? High what? High gadget designer, could be, but I prefer to say hi to make it general. I prefer to say hi, just again, high tech designer, okay, high tech designer, yep, this is it, high tech designer, high tech Nick. No, high tech designer, this is what was Adnan's job. Or dream, actually, dream job. So tennis player, good. Doctor or nurse, teacher, high tech designer. Well done, guys. Perfect. Muhammad is the first one. Muhammad wants the iPhone. Okay, so guys, our final thing to explain here is to talk about some pronunciation. So I think sometimes when you read English, guys, you can hear your teacher or you when you hear some movies or something, you can see that there are some words that has an S, maybe at the end, for example, or at the middle, it's okay. And yet we have to pronounce it as Z. There aren't any like specific grammatical rule. So basically English is a language that you have to listen. You can check sometimes in the dictionary. If you sometimes check in the dictionary, you'll find some words like cells. You'll find them like putting a Z between brackets. So you have to listen, you have to read in order to know the difference between why we have to say right, and here I have to say cells. So there aren't any rule that I can give you. Okay, so look at the first one. Mr. Pen writes. So it's an S and I pronounce it as an S for a magazine. But look here. John sells. So we pronounce this S as a Z. Z. Cameras in a store. S. Mr. Chang works. He writes works in a bank. My father drives. So this is Z. Drive a bus. See, it's not that complicated, guys. But you have to hear it. You have to read it. You have to pronounce it, to memorize it, and that's it. If you read it, pronounce it, if you check in dictionaries like Oxford or Longman or maybe Cambridge dictionaries, you will find them explaining the word. They will put in brackets that cells, you have to pronounce the last one as Z. So you can see them in dictionaries. So Pierre cooks in a restaurant. My brother plays volleyball. My brother plays volleyball. Okay, guys, so we are going now to have this passage, okay? And I want you to pay attention to me while I'm reading, okay? Pay attention to some words like the word that has a line here, the underlying word. Pay attention to my reading, and after that, I want one of you to read. So prepare yourself, guys. This is our last slide here in the lesson. Just listen to me carefully. Pay attention to the words that has an S at the end or in the middle, like this one. Okay, and see how I'm going to pronounce them. Okay, so two friends are talking. Two friends are talking. Patricia. I think I am coming down with something. Coming down, it means that she is going to be sick. When someone says that I'm coming down, it means that he is going to be sick. He is tired. I'm coming down with something. I started sneezing. Sneezing, so she may have the flu. I started sneezing yesterday. For no reason. No reason. Becky, this is her friend. There is a bad flu going around. So there is a flu in the air. You should go to bed for the day. Just go and rest in your bed. Patricia, you think so? I'm not sick yet. So she said that I'm still not sick, but I think that I'm going to be sick. So Becky said, I can usually sleep off the flu. Sleep off, guys, means that she went to sleep, she goes to sleep whenever she feels that she is sick. And after that, when she wakes up, she is okay. So she tried to fight sneezing or the flu by sleeping, sleep off. I can usually sleep off the flu before it gets bad. Before it gets bad. So she tries to fight the flu by sleeping. But I have to sleep a lot right after I get the first symptoms. Symptoms like the things that tells that you are sick, like sneezing, like coughing. They are called symptoms. Patricia, interesting. It's interesting. Maybe I'll try that. Maybe I'll try that. She means that she will try to sleep as Becky do. Becky, why not? Watch some movies. Watch some movies and take it easy. Watch some movies and take it easy. As you see, guys, some of the words that has an S, I pronounce them as S, and some of them I pronounce them as Z. So, does anyone want to try to read this one? Does any one of you wants to try to read with me? So, Muhammad, okay. Let me see, Muhammad, because he's the one that
Two friends are talking.
Okay.
Patricia, I think I am coming down with something. I started sneezing yesterday for no reason.
Good.
Becky, there's a bad flu going around. You should go to bed for the day. Patricia, you think so? I am not sick yet.
Yes.
Becky, I can usually sleep off the flu before it gets bad, but I have to sleep a lot right after I get the first symptoms.
Yep.
Symptoms.
Good. Yeah.
Patricia,
yeah.
Interesting. Maybe I try that. Becky, why not watch some movies and take it easy.
Easy. Okay, perfect, Muhammad. Really, I am impressed, Muhammad. You are amazing. Thank you. But Muhammad, I just want to say one thing. This is called I am. Don't say I am. Just try to make it fast. I am, not I am, because here it's written as one word. But excellent, excellent, excellent reading, Muhammad. So wonderful. So, Asya and Yazid, do you want to try again? Maybe you fixed your mic. You want me to give you a try? Or you want to read tomorrow? Because tomorrow we are going to have a reading lesson, inshallah. So tomorrow you have to read, all of you. Welcome, Mahmoud. You came at the last minute. So let's make the reading tomorrow for the rest of the guys, because we only have 5 minutes left. But thank you, Muhammad. Mahmoud, you really came late. So these are the words that have a Z. Reason, there is. Movies, easy, and also friends. Mahmoud, you came at the end of the class. So tomorrow, guys, tomorrow we are going to have the class at 6:15, okay, after the Maghrib prayer, okay? So not 8, tomorrow inshallah after the Maghrib prayer. Okay, so thank you guys for coming. Thank you, Muhammad, for reading. In this lesson, we have presented some listening activities. Okay, I hope to see you guys again tomorrow. I have some bad internet today, so thank you for participating, guys. You are amazing, and really, I hope to see you tomorrow, inshallah. So the references are SuperGoal, Full Plus, and some Google search engine.